participant, here are three tips to help you get through the grocery store line hassle-free.
Number one, shop at a WIC-approved store using your WIC ID card and your current WIC checks. Number two, make sure your WIC selections are approved and listed for purchase on your WIC checks. Number three, sign your WIC checks only after the date and the amount of your WIC purchase has been entered by the cashier.
By using these simple steps, you'll lessen your wait time in the checkout line.
This message is brought to you by the South Carolina Department of Health and Environmental Control.
When the weather heats up, most of us change our eating habits during the summer months. Lots of cookouts, plenty of outdoor activities. Well, here today to shed some light on how we can incorporate more of those fruits and vegetables into our summer diets is Rebecca Gillum Wren, a registered dietitian for the WIC program at South Carolina DHEC. Rebecca, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you. It's my pleasure to be here.
Well, what can we do? How do we get more of those fresh fruits and vegetables in our diet?
First thing you need to do, Wendy, is start with a plan.
Okay.
So when you go shopping, it's important to know what your schedule is for the week so you know how much to buy, because it's very frustrating to overbuy and then toss stuff in the trash later on in the week. We don't like to do that.
Yes.
So you start with a plan, and then you start every meal with a fresh fruit or vegetable, or a canned or frozen, or however you want to do it, you know, whatever works for your family for that day. But have one at every meal or snack. Try to incorporate them there. And then, if you eat like the rainbow and have lots of different colors, you should be able to build a beautiful plate and have a great variety of fruits and vegetables.
Well, it's interesting. You talk about fruits and vegetables, and I know that WIC has implemented a new program that allows WIC customers to actually purchase more fruits and vegetables. Tell us how that works.
Well, there are actually two ways that they can do that, and I want to make the difference known for you. You have the fresh and frozen fruit and vegetable voucher, and you can buy any fresh or frozen in the grocery store as long as it doesn't have added salt, sugar, fat, or sauce. Salad kits you can't buy, you know, those things that have the croutons and some other little bits and pieces thrown in, or white potatoes.
Okay.
So any of those work, and you can use those also at the authorized farmers markets. Now, the other one is the farmers market voucher, and it can only be used at the farmers market for certain kinds of items like South Carolina fresh produce. It's a program in conjunction with the South Carolina Department of Agriculture. And if you want to know where your local markets are, you can go to the website. You can either go to the DHEC website, or you can go to South Carolina Department of Agriculture website, and they'll, you know, you can click around in there, and I think it's up at the top of the Department of Agriculture, and it'll give you a list of where all of the authorized markets are in your area.
Oh, that's wonderful. So when you are buying, say, for example, if you're going to the farmer's market, you have to go to one that is WIC approved.
Absolutely.
And you have to buy those products that are listed on your WIC voucher.
Well, they have to be South Carolina grown.
South Carolina grown
right.
products. Okay. Well, you know, I'm guilty of this, and maybe everybody else is getting it right, but you go into the grocery store, you look at these beautiful grapes, they look wonderful, you get them home, and they're horrible. You know, most people just don't know how, it's hit or miss, they don't know how to select
right.
fresh produce. Any tips on what we should be looking for when we buy fresh produce?
Sure. Let's start with two of our favorites,
okay.
Watermelons and cantaloupes.
Yay.
South Carolina. If you get a watermelon, what you want to do is make sure, because watermelons do not continue to ripen up after you buy them, unlike cantaloupes.
Right, okay.
So when you buy your watermelon, what you've got is what you've got. So you want to turn it over and make sure that the underbelly has a little bit of yellow on it, because that shows you that it's been sitting in the field and wasn't picked too soon.
Oh, okay.
That's one of the tricks. And you want to thump it, listen to it, make sure it sounds right, check the ends, make sure they're not too squishy, you know, that it's overripe. And with cantaloupes, you want to choose a cantaloupe that has got, you know, a nice roundness to it, or it might be oblong shape, and it has what's a webbing on the outside. You want to look and make sure there's a little bit of greenish or yellowish tinge. And after you use your eyes, then you want to use your nose. You want to turn it up and smell it. Actually smell to make sure that it smells like a nice cantaloupe should smell. And if you touch the tip end where the stem was, it should be smooth, not, you know, like it was yanked out of the field or anything. And you want to make sure it's soft.
That it's soft.
That it's a little bit soft.
Oh, okay.
And then when you get those home, you want to make sure that you rinse them off to get the dirt off. Because a lot of people don't realize that when you take the knife to cut it, you're contaminating mm-hmm. the inside just from what was on the outside. And, you know, things are handled a lot in the market before you get them home. And you can even use a little scrub brush on the outside if you want to. You don't use soap. Just rinse it off nicely and dry it off before you put it on your counter to cut it up.
Okay. Now, are there certain selections, maybe on the vegetable side especially, that are no-cook options for those people who are watching that may not be high on cooking during the summer that they can purchase for their family?
Sure. Any of the peppers and cucumbers and tomatoes. And a thing that I just learned about tomatoes said that when you rinse tomatoes, it should be at 10 degrees higher than what your room temperature is so that you don't migrate the bacteria that goes through the tomatoes. I never heard that.
Wow.
Because a lot of times now people want to eat the peel for the extra fiber.
Right, right. So you can. So tomatoes are one of those things mm-hmm. that we can mix with just about
Absolutely.
Anything. I love cucumbers, and that's one of the things that we kind of, in our house, cucumbers don't last long because everybody eats them.
And with cucumbers, you want to make sure that they are, you know, long enough, but they're not really fat, because the bigger and rounder they are, the bigger the seeds will be on the inside.
Okay, interesting. Now, are there certain types of fruits and vegetables that we should be cautious about for our children?
It depends on the age of the child. About 7 or 8 months, they can begin to eat table food that has been cooked. And you want to mush it up with a fork, because they don't really have molars in the back first set of molars until they're about 2. So they can't chew so good.
Mm-hmm.
So you want to mash and peel and mash the stuff for the little babies. And then for 7 to 8 months. And then after they've got their 2-year molars, they can begin to branch out to some different textures. But Wendy, did you know that the number one cause of accidental death for children in the United States under the age of 2 is choking?
No, I didn't know that.
So you want to make sure that whatever it is not a circle like a carrot. You
mm-hmm.
want to cut it into some little pieces for them. Grapes especially, you want to cut in half.
Okay.
Cherries, anything that has pits or seeds, you really need to be careful with the children.
That's good advice, because I didn't realize that was
mm-hmm.
the number one cause of death was choking. Interesting. Well, we can't wait to see some of these things on the harvested table now that we know how to go in and select our fruits and vegetables. You mentioned the website, and I know we're going to put a full screen up.
If they want the locations for the vendors, yes, that's
okay.
going to be on the website.
All right. Well, Rebecca, thank you so much for joining us today. It's always a pleasure to have you in, and we look forward to seeing some of those recipes in the coming months.
Thank you.